Lesser trochanteric fractures. The femur is the longest and strongest tubular bone in the human body and one of the principal load-bearing bones in the lower extremity. The thigh bone has two bony processes on the upper part, the greater and lesser trochanters. The lesser trochanter lies on the posteromedial aspect of the proximal femur, inferior to the femoral neck. The iliopsoas muscle inserts on the lesser trochanter. The psoas muscle is a long muscle located in the lower back area of the spine and extends through the pelvis to the femur or thigh bone. This muscle helps to flex your hips, bend your trunk towards your thighs, and rotate your femur. The psoas and iliacus muscles join together to constitute one single tendon known as the iliopsoas and inserts onto the lesser trochanter of femur. Isolated trochanteric fractures usually result from forceful muscular contraction of a fixed limb. In children, since the attachment sites of tendons are stronger than the growth plate, with sudden forceful contraction of the muscles due to athletic activities, avulsion of the apophysis occurs. Such injuries may also result from chronic microtrauma or overuse, as in ballet dancers. At the age of 18, the lesser trochanteric apophysis is fused. After this age, such fractures are uncommon, and most cases are pathological fractures due to malignant lesions, and occur without overt trauma. Sometimes, lesser trochanteric fracture is the presenting symptom before the diagnosis of underlying tumor. Among older adults, isolated fractures of the trochanter can occur from direct trauma such as a motor vehicle accident, or any accident that puts sudden stress on the hip, such as a fall. Symptoms and diagnosis. Lesser trochanteric fractures generally cause pain in the groin, but may also present with knee, buttocks or posterior thigh pain. That is worse with hip flexion and rotation. A snapping or clicking sensation in the hip or groin. Shuffling gait which presents as short steps and narrow based, or limping gait. The fracture is diagnosed through a review of the medical history. The doctor will perform a detailed physical examination. Fractured parts of the bone can be seen by conventional X-ray, anteroposterior and lateral views. MRI scans of the hip and pelvis may be needed in some cases to confirm the diagnosis. In adolescents with painful limp, other differential diagnoses should be considered such as slipped capital femoral epiphysis, Peart's disease, and infectious arthritis. For more information about other causes of hip pain in kids, you can watch the video that has been published which is titled, Causes of Hip Pain in Children. Treatment. Most lesser trochanteric avulsion fractures heal well without surgical intervention. We recommend non-operative treatment for all lesser trochanteric fractures with less than 20 millimeters of displacement. We recommend a period of rest and non-weight-bearing for 4 to 6 weeks, followed by protected weight-bearing with crutches or a walker for another 4 to 6 weeks. Physical therapy and stretching exercises to improve muscle strength, restore range of motion, and promote healing. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, to reduce pain. Sports activities are avoided till healing is present, which can take up to 16 to 20 weeks. Surgical management is indicated for displaced fractures greater than 2 centimeters. Symptomatic non-union, and inability to return to sports. Postoperatively, a hinged hip brace will be applied to keep the hip flexed, and the patient will be instructed to remain toe-touch weight-bearing for 6 weeks. At 6 weeks postoperatively, the patient will be allowed to bear weight as tolerated. The patient will enter a physical therapy program to improve muscle strength, restore range of motion. At 6 months postoperatively, the patient will regain full range of hip motion and return to her previous level of sport, Patients with malignancy are treated with surgery, chemotherapy, or radiation, depending on the pathologic nature and the stage of underlying tumor.